No, hub motors are not waterproof. You may have seen photos like these of rusted hub motors floating around the internet, and if you're anything like me, you might be curious to know why this happens. Metal gets wet, metal gets rusty. Yeah, okay, but why is water getting into the hub motors? And are they just simply destined for an oxidized future? Well, some people on the interwebs believe so. In fact, some people believe that in its current form, it is virtually impossible to keep water out of a hub motor on a personal electric scooter. Is that true? Maybe. My name is Nick, and I like small things that move people. Consider subscribing for regular content. But I want to take a look and see if this is actually the case. Are hub motors on personal scooters going to fail the weather test? So let's go back to the rusted motors. These come from two different scooters, the Xiaomi M365 Pro and the Cabo Mantis 10. And these scooters are quite different, but they share one thing in common, an IP rating of IPX4. If you don't know what that means, check out my video on IP ratings, but essentially these scooters have a pretty basic water resistance rating. They should not be ridden in the rain, and to be honest, you should avoid standing water with them as much as possible, just to be safe, because it's not only the motors that are susceptible to water damage.
Mantis 10, water damage. Mantis 10, water damage. Mantis 10, water damage. Your Mantises are not waterproof. If you want to ride them in the rain, don't ride them in the rain.
But yeah, those are the ones that shouldn't be around much water, but what about those that are touted as the best rain-worthy scooters? Now, I can't test them all, but I happen to own two in the wet-ready category, and I've already put them through thousands of kilometers in Vancouver's rainy weather. So, let's open them up. Starting with the Ninebot Max G30P, rated at IPX5. And if the ravings online are to be believed, this thing is the best thing since sliced bread. It's basically the Honda Civic of scooting. When someone is looking for a scooter that is going to see some wet conditions, this will undoubtedly be at or near the top of the list. Now, let's open this guy up. I've had the scooter for almost a year now, and it has about 2,500 kilometers on it, and it was my commuter until I upgraded and has seen its fair share of rain. Initially, in the battery compartment, we can see it is clean. There was no sign of water getting in at all. Before opening the motor, I disconnected it from the power. And it's also clean, and this was a surprise to me because the cocksuredness online was to the extent that it had me believe that no matter what the manufacturer told you, no matter what kind of DIY silicone solution you came up with, water getting into hub motors is basically a certainty if you plan to regularly ride it in the rain like I did. But here we have, at least to my eyes, a rust-free motor. Next up is my Apollo City Pro, and I've had this for just 4 months. I got it the first week of November of 2022, just as the rainy season started. So even though it only has half the mileage of the Ninebot Max at 1,200 kilometers, there is no doubt it has seen more rain. I have ridden this in all weather, in light rain, crazy downpours, even in the snow, though that usually doesn't go so well. This is a bit different than most scooters. There are two layers protecting the battery and controller. The first is this plastic shell, which does actually show some signs of water ingress. The front probably from me spraying water up below the neck when cleaning, and the rear where the brake cable comes through. But the battery and controller housing is all metal and is sealed up pretty nicely with a supple rubber lining and grommets for the wires. And the rear motor cable grommet even has sealant to help prevent liquid entry. I didn't notice anything inside the housing. It's clean and dry, so I disconnected the rear motor. Now, this motor was definitely a bit more difficult to open than the Max. The screws which fasten the motor cover to the rim needed a Torx bit and required quite a lot of force to come loose. I actually destroyed one of my bits in the process. But anyway, there you have it. As far as I could tell, there was no visible rust on either side of the motor. And again, I was pleasantly surprised considering the abuse it has put up with so far. Like, my colleague nicknamed it the diarrhea machine because of the filthy puddles it leaves when I bring it to work. So to see all the vital components dirt and rust free is a great sign. However, look at some of the other unprotected components. Rainwater is not good for it. I took this opportunity to completely disassemble the rear suspension, and there is plenty of rust to be found. But the motors? Well, we have two dry ones, which begs the question. How has water not ingressed thus far? Like I said, both of these scooters have seen their fair share of rain. Well, I can point to three features. One is where the wire enters the axle. This is an obvious place for ingress. The wire itself seems to plug the hole quite well. And on top of that, you can see in both motors, there is silicone covering the electrical connections. And it looks like it seals up the entrance of the wires, but I can't be sure without completely destroying the motors. The second are these bearing covers, best seen on the Ninebot Max. They create a barrier between the bearings and the elements. And even though this is probably the best place for ingress, considering it's a moving part, it certainly has done its job well, which I think is in large part to the multiple rings and the proper application of grease. The third is only seen on the Apollo, which are these rubber grommets on both hub covers, which of course help keep water out at the seams. So these measures have clearly worked at keeping a fatal amount of moisture from getting in. And the key point here are the conditions. Is it virtually impossible to keep water out of a hub motor? Well, maybe, but like, what are the conditions? If I completely submerge the scooter in water, it probably won't stand a chance. But in regular riding conditions, so like, whatever, various levels of rain, standing water, whatever, I am convinced they are adequately sealed for those conditions. Does it mean it's waterproof? No, and it doesn't mean moisture might not get in at some point. Components fail, rubber breaks down, and you know, you do a crappy job of putting it back together. Weatherproof? I would say yes, because there they are, two hub motors that have survived the rust this far. That being said, this is just a sample. Just because these have survived doesn't mean you shouldn't avoid water if possible, and it doesn't mean others with these exact scooters will 100% have the same experience. Because remember, rust never sleeps, but with proper maintenance, I believe these should last for a long time. So with that, my name is Nick. Thanks for watching.